Good morning, everybody. Happy Sunday to you. Good morning, Michaela. Thank you for patiently waiting. I'm Ben. This is Ben's Brick Designs. Thanks for being here on this wonderful, hopefully rainy Sunday here in Austin, Texas. That's the big news around Austin, is that it's raining. Boa tarde to you, Walter and Mariana, if she's watching. Thank you for being here all the way from Portugal. Good Sunday to you. So today I'm doing some design stuff. I had this great idea. I don't know if you saw the community post on YouTube, but I had this great idea. Got a bunch of great ideas to do a new theme, classic space theme. And then I was going to submit it to Lego Ideas until I read the rules on Lego Ideas, and they're like, no themes, no like giant groups of things that all go together. And I was like, hello, Miss Bricks. How are you? Thanks for being here. I appreciate those of you watching who aren't watching Good Morning Brick World. I realize that's a big thing. Feel free to bounce over there until they're done. I'll be here for 2 hours. So thanks for being here. Appreciate your viewership. Hello, Mayo. Did somebody say Mayo? I just did. So this is what I've come up with so far. The idea I had was to do, and I may abandon this because whatever. The idea I had was to do a terraforming space group. So we've got like police and we've got bad guys and we've got good guys and we've got explorers and all the stuff from like the 80s, 90s space themes like Futron, and M-tron and Ice Planet, and all those seem to be like exploring. But there's also sort of like a crime and police kind of thing going on, renegades and law enforcement. I wanted something that was a more sort of pure exploration, scientists, or like discovery, research, that kind of thing. So I thought terraforming would be good. This is a bit much. I've got the Surprise Me channel on Pretzel, and I think that's a bit much. So then I had an idea where you have these little pods that you can pilot around, and they all become the pilot of the vehicle that you're in. So you get a big vehicle, you get this little pod that lands in it, and now you can drive that vehicle around, and they all have little docking stations, and all the bases have docking stations for these pods too. So I built a little pod, and I'm very proud of this pod because it is basically a 8 wide, 1, 2, 3, I mean like 6.5 wide. It's not very big. And it kind of looks like a VW bus. But the cool thing is it's got a reversed stud, so it's a bit of a snot build. And I had to make it so I could get a figure in there. So there is a figure in there, right? He sits in there. The trick is, though, he's not sitting very well. He just kind of sits. He's not sitting in or attaching to anything, but, you know, he's got a little place where he's cozy and he'll stay put. And if you close these, he's not going anywhere, right? So a couple things that stopped me from doing this is, first of all, these pieces don't come in tan. And so I wanted the whole color scheme to be tan with highlights, like tan and green, tan and orange, to give it sort of, everything's got this uniform, terraforming kind of look. So I'll bring the designs up and we'll do some work on that. If anyone wants me for this week, I'll be studying, preparing for my 12-hour sorting party. If you need to sort Lego, DM me. I mean, who here doesn't need to sort Lego? I need to do two things with my Lego stuff. I need to do reinventory of our lugs stuff because I just got two more boxes of support from Lego that I've added to our inventory, but I need to go through the box and make sure what they've marked down is what's actually in there. But there's also, I feel, a bunch of boxes and bags that I have that aren't inventoried right. And I just kind of took it on faith when I took the inventory list from the previous group person that it was done. And there's like a bag of like a bunch of Mixels, or there's a bag of like CMFs or something. And I'd like to know what is actually in there. And I'm not great at that kind of stuff. So that's going to take a little bit. But then there's also just regular sorting. I've got a ton of stuff to sort through. And so this is where the design came from. This is the design now. So these are the kind of colors that I was looking at. I thought this was kind of a cool, kind of, you know, I seem to be a sucker for tan, but I thought tan would be a kind of a neat color scheme. I don't necessarily think tan and green or tan and orange, either one is good. I couldn't get an orange space fig thing right here, but imagine that's orange. None of these pieces, like almost none of these pieces exist. None of these pieces in the legs exist individually as tan, but these torsos don't exist in tan. These arms don't exist in tan. So the idea was I would do this for ideas, and have renders, and then Lego can print up whatever colors they want, right? I'm sure it'd be redesigned anyway once it gets to the vote, past the voting stage and into the judging stage, and then they get their own designers to do it. But this took a lot of work to get these things built properly, and you can kind of see they come apart pretty easily to see. It's just, you know, one of those modified plates and then a modified brick, and they're just, you know, these pieces here. They come off in pretty decent halves. The one thing I really liked was that, I don't know if you can see it, the reversal was those 1x1 plates that have the little fishing reels on them, to kind of turn those over so I could put these on. But it's pretty simple. Once I figured it out, it was pretty simple. But the fact that they don't allow themes was kind of a gut punch, because I had had this plan of doing a couple bases, a couple big vehicles, some medium vehicles, and some small vehicles, just like the old themes were, where it was like 15 or so sets of various sizes, right? And it looked great when it was all together. Y'all remember to like the stream, you hear? Thank you very much. They kind of look like sandwiches. They do look like sandwiches. They look like little burgers, right? But the idea kind of got dropped because unless I'm going to do this by myself, and the more I thought about it, the pod idea was okay. But if you're landing a pod on one side of a base and walking to another vehicle where there's a pod linked in, or if there's, you know, so the idea was you could get one of these and it would go into any vehicle that you got. But every vehicle came with a pod, so why not just have the person in the vehicle? So I'm kind of redoing the whole thought process, and I thought I'd still try to do one for an ideas set. So I started doing a base, but I think I'm going to redo this as well, because this would have been like one of the big bases, and most bases of that theme era were about 2 base plates. So you'd have, you know, a docking area for 3 of them. And then I was going to do like a storage area. Let's see if I got a drawing of it. This is the latest drawing. It's a little storage area with a big dome on it and place to park it. And then there's a little hill, and there's like a big dome that's kind of like on stilts. Like there's areas to do stuff underneath with some storage next to it. And then there's like a habitable dome up on top, which you could kind of take off modular style and kind of see what's all the stuff inside, that kind of thing. So, but not going to do that anymore. So what I thought I'd do is maybe start a new project, and we'll just start from scratch. Now, what I was kind of hoping to do is just do some plates and get maybe a big footprint of just a base. So we'll do same color, and I mean, because Blacktron, the base plates were all black, and Ice Planet, the base plates were all white and blue. M-tron didn't have any bases. The only difference is, I think, is a lot of the other ones, Futron and I think Explorians, they all had like gray or dark gray base plates for their bases. They didn't, you know, exactly match, but we can do tan. The idea is they're on like a rocky planet and they're terraforming. So I'm going to keep with that idea. But I also don't want to just do base plates. I think if I'm going to design this new, it should be with like the medieval forge, to where it's the kind of angular or not straight lined footprint. So have it kind of bump out in areas and have it be rocky and stuff. So let's find one of these that we can do in the right color. I don't know which ones are which. So we can get that in tan. That's good. It's $3. Not bad. What about this one? All right. So that's a good start. So what I was thinking is let's pull over a dude so we can get scale. Let's pull over these two dudes. Because I still like the idea of the having those space guys like that. Now, terraforming can do a lot of, can have a lot of different areas. And if I'm just doing one base, it's going to be a little weird. But if I do one big base, I can also have like a mid to small size land vehicle and a big ship. So I can do one big thing and have it, you know, because there are bases in that 80s, 90s theme that had a ship that went with it and had a little car that went with it. So that's kind of the look I'm going to go for. So we can have four or five minifigures, maybe more, one or two with the big ship, one with the little ground vehicle, three or four to put on the base. And I was thinking of sort of a V-shaped base. So let's go ahead and maybe put out a footprint of that. So we've got these guys here and we have that as like a main thing. Let's just plan. This is just plan. So let me show off a little bit of stuff that we did for our lug recently. I don't think I posted this anywhere, like Instagram or anything. I think I still have it up. Sorry, that took a little longer than I thought. There was some dead air there. What's up, Synthetic Mason? Do these little guys have an antagonist for the theme? So here's the thing, not yet, but that was something I really didn't like about, because Classic Space didn't. I don't like the idea that there is an automatic antagonist for a theme, right? I think for Terraformers, the antagonist is the planet. They are working against odds to get a planet terraformed, so it's more about the perseverance and the research and the dedication, which is kind of a weird thing to put in a toy. Like, you got to have somebody fighting each other. Otherwise, there's no, you know. But I liked the idea of it not being a built-in. Like, if there was a whole other theme, that you can kind of maybe, like, eco-terrorists, people who are like, no, we shouldn't, you know, why are we terraforming these planets? You know, that'd be a cool thing to do. And that's something that, but again, I can't really pitch a theme to ideas. So the idea of just, this is just one big base and it's a terraforming base. And I like the name TerraTron. I thought that was pretty cool. So we did this recently. I'm going to pull up the full camera because I don't have my build camera ready. But so this was something we did. This is a thing you can do for your lug. If you are in a lug, we did recently minifigs on parade. So this is a kind of a standard size, and you can look this up, minifigs on parade. You basically build an 8x16 plate, and then you have like a 6x8 plate as a road and, you know, side, and then you can do kind of whatever you want on the side, right? For instance, and then you build a kind of not mills plate style, but kind of like half mills plates where you got this so it can connect to other parade sections, and so you can do stuff like this where that's your parade, right? It's just a dude with some cobblestone things, and then I did a Star Wars one. It's a stormtrooper walking down a hall, the inlet designs there, and I got some piping behind the wall, conduits and stuff. So then the idea is you put them all together and line up a big table. And you've got this great collaborative build that everybody can contribute to. You know, and you've got a bunch of different minifigs walking down streets and stuff. So we did that for our lug and had a lot of great examples of it. They were really, really good. Michaela had one that was really fun with David Bowie. So it was a lot of fun. So if you're in a lug and you guys are looking for things to do collaboratively, that's a great, and it's easy. You just get, it doesn't even have to be an 8x16 plate. Just have it that size. So a couple 8x8s together, whatever. So yeah. So the other thing I think terraformers need, and I'm going to work on this. This may need to be a bigger base size. Is that I feel like they would have some sort of dome for plants. So we can have something split off to be like, this is the communications area. This is where the vehicles dock. This is where the crew stays. You know, it's got all this stuff that could be involved, but you got to make it into a size that is one base large. Like, it can't be overly big or else it's not a good set. But it also has to make sense. So this could be like part of where all the plants live in a big dome. They're gonna have like a docking bay over here for a ship, and then maybe like a little communications thing in a tower. We'll put that like this. So this is, I'm also gonna try to make this look like it's built into rocks. So I'm picking these instead of base plates, because base plates are an odd thin size compared to just regular plates. And if you try to do that mix and match of curved or round or wedge plates to give it kind of a ground look, you can't really do that with a base plate, because they would shoot out at odd angles and they wouldn't be real flush with the ground. But this is kind of the thing I was thinking of. So if we do plate modify, so we'll have plate rounds, because we'll have those big corner like this, and this, and this maybe, and this, maybe that, and all these are gonna have to come in the right colors. So just put this out here and see which ones do and which ones don't. Probably not that one, but we'll see. This is the fun part, right? So I wouldn't be opposed to having like some dark tan in here as well for rocks and whatever. Thinking like a deserty, rocky planet. Throw in a Genesis joke in here, maybe. Oh, wait. Sorry. Yeah. Thanks. So all I'm really doing is pulling out wedge plates. It's no big deal. And then seeing which ones come in tan. All right, so that one doesn't, does it come in dark tan? No, it doesn't come in anything useful. You're gone. What about that? Dark bluish gray. Really, these little guys don't come in tan? That's a shame. Gone. Thought they come in dark tan. Yeah, so we can change that to dark tan just in case. Those don't come in anything useful. That's not medium nougat, maybe. If I was doing like a canyon look. Okay, I'm not a fan. Not a fan. Dark bluish gray, dark tan. Okay, so we've got a couple dark tans there. If we wanted to incorporate. All right, cool. So yeah, so this is the kind of thing where you just kind of, it's gonna be a little awkward because Studio doesn't like doing this. Kind of want to make it a little rounded, or angled. I can fill that in with a plate. Could do bits like this. Have you seen Silent Running? The ship in that movie is very terraformy in design. Also, were you thinking any non-human characters like drone or creature to give your characters company? I have seen Silent Running, but it's been a very long time. It's that big, it's that long ship with like the three domes on it, and it's like the drama in that movie is hilarious. I probably should watch it again because it's one of these classic bad movies. But it's like actually, it's weirdly good, but it's also weirdly bad. So I need to watch it again. And I haven't considered giving them... So the idea of terraforming is you find a lifeless rock. Like if there were aliens on this planet, they wouldn't be trying to terraform it. But like when Classic Space came out and Futuron came out and Blacktron came out, and all those early space things, there weren't any aliens. I think the first aliens that came out were... Was it Life on Mars? With the rounded head people? They were almost like mini doll figures. And then after that, everything had an alien of some kind attached to it. The new... Like the Blacktron 3 series and Galaxy Patrol or Galaxy Guardians or something like that. They all had that. Let's make this a 4 plate. Can I change all this to tan? But yeah, if you don't know what Travis is talking about, this is Silent Running. It's this, not the new one, because I think they remade it. Yeah, it's super cool. That'd be a fun ship just to make, I think, in Lego. It's very Battlestar Galactica-y. But yeah, that idea where there's got to be plant life in here. So that's another thing that we'll have to figure out is a dome. And you can see already this is getting pretty sprawly. But if we look at how big a base plate would be. 32. So if we just did 32 by 32. And we did two of those together. That's still not, you know... That's not too much bigger. And I'm going to look up real quick. Is it... The Explorians? Yeah, they didn't have... Their bases weren't that big. But this is kind of the idea I'm thinking of. Something like this. You know, it's not a huge thing, but it's still a couple base plates. Was it Spireus? I don't think Spireus ever had a base, but I may be wrong. Oh, they did. That's cool. But see, that came on that one platform that was like, and most of these are just like, here's a dome thing and we're going to stick a computer in there. That was their base. So I'm not going to stray too far from that idea. Spireus also, I forget if they were the first ones, but they had robots as their figures, these guys. And I don't know if that was the first ones. Robo Guardians also came with these guys. Yeah, so that's the kind of thing I'm thinking of. So, like, this is obviously the classic monorail space set, but you can see the base in that was kind of, you know, it's just a base plate with some stuff inside it. It wasn't super complicated. It's all about the play. So, and here's another base that you can get. So you could attach this to the monorail set, which is what I did too. But again, just a little computer, little car that parks there. It has a rocket that lands in there that you can put a dude in. Simple stuff, right? So footprint may not be as important, but I want to kind of lay it out a little bit. I think this would be kind of cool. Maybe even have it open and close, kind of like the cantina or something, where you can kind of open it to see all the workings inside it. But let's... I'm trying to think of what a good dome shape would be. Because you can get those dome... these guys, but I don't know what color these are available in. Trans dark blue, trans green. That wouldn't be too bad. To go along with the green green of the theme. Trans yellow. This part in trans yellow is $86. That's funny. In trans green, I think it was less. $44. What is trans blue? $30. I've got like three of those. These are the cheapest. I don't necessarily want those because they're cool, but they're awfully big and tall. I don't necessarily want a tall dome like that. And you would need to do, you need to leave it open so they could see. Why does that not want to? Is this just a part that doesn't like to attach to things? Oh, sweet Jesus. Yeah, so this is just a part that doesn't like, that's broken. The joining areas are broken. Yeah, so not that. I want more like a low level, dome. And I wouldn't even mind it, it's windscreen. Completely closed in. But it needs to be sort of a pan angled like this. What the heck? No, thank you. Like this. That would be really good. Because we can make... What colors do those come in? Trans black, that'd be really good. Doesn't come in trans clear though. So you can do this at an angle, kind of like that. So you can attach it down here. That rotational, oof. We have to attach it first to see if I can rotate it. So the angle is good where you can, and I need to color this something different so I can actually see what I'm doing. You can leave these together. So this is the one thing I'm not a fan of once you rotate something is if you try to move it, it tries to snap. I think if I turn snap off, that would do it. What's up, Scott? How's it going? These are too straight. Like, they aren't a... We may have to build a dome of some kind, because I don't think we've got a... just a straight canopy that is angled all the way across. I say as I find that. You know, you see how it's angled here and then straight as it gets into the back? It needs to be angled the entire time. And that's straight the entire time. And that's straight the entire time. All right, so we'll figure out something else. But we can also do... Zisu, hi, how are you? Bar 4L. So we can have that, and then we can have the bar holder. We can have these pieces. And I think it's a modified tile. These pieces. And you can do a bunch of different things with this for dome frames. So this can be a good dome frame. And have that... like that. I don't know why I copied that. And you can have those meet at a central location. It'd be a modified plate. That octagon thing. This thing, and you get, how do I attach that? Oh, just like this. We take, get rid of that. So you just get a bunch of these, and then you've got a dome, and you can put plants in it. Hey, Meredith, how's it going? Meredith is an IRL friend who lives here in Austin with me. Not with me, but she's here in Austin. How's your day going, Mare? Are you ready for House of the Dragon? You gonna watch that? See, this is what I need to do. I need to be able to turn this, but it won't let me. So let's do these four to start. Oh, accidentally got the right angle. Oh, you got an Oculus? Wow. Haircuts, Sandman. Yeah, the latest Sandman episode is super fun. I kind of am sad that Rory was the bad guy in this one, but I'm like, yeah, he's still a good actor. He plays like a pedagogue really well. Like the, I'm, learn from me because I'm a great writer. Yeah, House of Dragon, House of the Dragon, or House of Dragon, or whatever, releases tonight. How did I accidentally... Oh, what a... That's so dumb. Oh, that may be a neat little tip. Like, if it's not connecting, you can just keep rotating it till it connects. How did I do that? Thank you. That is so funny. Wasn't Portugal used a lot in Game of Thrones too? He played Shakespeare in the audible version of Sandman. That's cool. Yeah, I'm like, I can't wait. And Beth is like, no, I don't care. She wasn't a big Game of Thrones fan, so even when we were doing watch parties, she's like, do I have to go? And I'm like, you don't have to. She's like, I'm not going to watch it. Okay, well, this is dumb. Turn just a little bit so I can make you connect. And then make you connect. It was in there. Tis what she proclaimed. All right, so the whole reason we're doing that, oh, and it's not a real good angle. Nuts. Okay, so dome. Right. No, I'm trying to make, and then we can do another cross here. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to make a dome for terraforming, like a terraforming space station dome. This is a lot harder to do in the software than it is in real life. But if I don't do it in the software, I don't know what pieces that I'm going to need to order to make it in real life. Hence, which is the perpetual struggle. Uh-oh. That should be... why is that not straight? I would think that would be... huh, I'm gonna have to play with this in real life and see if I can make that work. All right, cool, Scott. Thanks. Yeah, the cat short was real good. The extra episode was real good. So yeah, something about this big, let's say. Let me get rid of this just because it's distracting, but... we can group that together and we can kind of say it goes over here. I'm sure it will fit somewhere. Right about there. And then we'll have a little, you know, there's a little door or something over here, and then we'll put some plants inside there. It doesn't have to be huge. It just has to give like the indication of this is a dome that you put in plants, right? Save as base 2. I might still use these pods for something, but I don't really know what. I don't know. Maybe I'll build them into... I was starting to do build them into vehicles. Like just you can dock in a frame and then have a little car there, but I don't know. Does the software ever recommend a certain piece? No. Not that I'm aware of. What do you mean by recommend a certain piece? I don't know how it would know what piece I want. pew pew vroom. So let's say this is all white too, or gray. I don't like dark bluish gray. That doesn't look right with the rest of this. Does white look better? No. blue gray. I mean, all right. Let's leave it tan. We'll put some accents on it with something else. You know nothing of the program. In a it looks like you're trying to build a space station. So this is going to be frustrating because this, as a group, you can see the bounding box is angled for one of these right here, which is a problem. So I may end up releasing all that. So I can get that floor back to where it was. Because otherwise every new piece I place is going to be placed lower. No, you kind of have to know. I mean, you can type over here. Like, if you think you want something, you're like, I don't know, it's a plate. And you type in plate. And you can scroll through here. And you're like, okay, well, I don't know. I need a 2x3 plate. It'll come up with everything that's got 2x3 and plate in its name. And then you can kind of pick from there. But you do have to know what Bricklink's name of the piece is, so. No, and it doesn't really recommend pieces for you, but that's why I like doing this live with people who also build stuff. I know Travis has even sent me, like, while I was streaming, like, Instagram messages of something he's built, and he's like, try that. I'm like, cool. Tubing. Thanks, man. James with the rescue. Rigid tubing. The cool thing about the tubing, too, is you can bend it. So what I can do, I like the rigid frame, but pull that back out here. Let's get a shorter one. Even this size. That's too small. That may be a good size. That may be a better size. So if we did this, you said it was a good size. It's probably good pointing out a little bit. Here's the other thing. What colors did that one come in? Dark, light blue gray. For $4. Yorks. Copper? Interesting. Reddish gold? Cheaper? Black. 30 cents. Even in the software, you should be able to bend the tubing a little bit. Except this is obviously rigid tubing doesn't bend very well. It doesn't bend like that. And I think that's too big. Try this one a little bit. And you can always, here's the things that I know a lot of people don't want to tell you, but you can get longer tubes and cut them. Nope, I just want select and bend. It's so sad. Because again, as soon as you click, this is those very rigid tubes, but as soon as you click on it, it goes, physics, physics. Don't be a size queen, Ben. Let's see if we can do a smaller one that will give us. Okay, so let's try that. And I want to see if it just gives us, we can also stretch it. Nope, okay. So slightly bigger than that. Yeah, this is good. That's good for the bending stuff is actually pretty good for if you have string pieces or chains. This is really good for that because you can kind of wrap chains around wheels in your design or you can have strings go across a thing. But for like rigid tubes like this where you're just like, I just want to bend it a little bit. It's like the simulation, the physics simulation, the rigid body simulation isn't like amazing. It's not like we're working in Blender or something. See, I know it's not that long. I know it's shorter than that, but... What's up, Cliff? It has a scary, anatomically correct, incorrect Halloween animal skeleton. Neat. So yeah, so that's a thing you can do. You can bend... a tube in the software. So for all you people new to the software, that's something you can do. And we can do this over here and try this again. That looks a little better. So yeah, do that all the way around, maybe something like that. Bye, Mare. See you later. We need to hang out in real life at some point again. And Clickin' Cliff is here. You can also probably, instead of these things like this, you can also do a tube up to here. So you can do bent tubes all the way around and then rigid tubes in between. So, I mean, it's really a matter of how you want to build it. But yeah, so that'll be the dump. So what I'm kind of going for is, terraforming dome, just, you know, just a regular geodesic dome kind of thing. Look for probably like this, almost exactly like this, right? Where it's just got some plants inside. So what we can do is kind of leave it as is, and then I'm going to move it over here. When it jumps around like that, it's really like kind of freaky. Thank you, Windows Defender. I don't need to be talking to you right now. Okay. Move it over to kind of where we want it. And then move it over, move it down, a little lower. Okay. So probably a door like right here. So we get rid of that. If I have to figure out how to do a door, but it'd be like an airlock. Actually, I would probably rotate this whole thing, and I'll tell you why in a second. No, I don't want to move. Oh, it's not letting me rotate it the way I want to. That is so weird. It's still attached. So I think what I need to do is build it from... Instead of building it from the arm first, I need to build it from this down. Because I want these panels to be... why won't it let me? There we go. That's the one I want. I want it to be that way. So I can have like a door... That's even not even what I want. Ow, ow. It's so weird. Why is it?
Um,
Wanting to rotate so funny. I don't understand what's going on. Anyway, yeah, so one of these panels off to the side so I can have like a straight door, and you just put a door in there, a door frame. You can build out a door frame, but I find that just putting one of these in there is fine. And you don't have to put an actual door in there. You can kind of space it out a little bit by putting something sliding behind it or making the hallway a little wider so you can have slidey bits in it that you can control from the top either way. You can't just put your thing down, flip it, and reverse it. So put that like right there. And then over here, I'm imagining kind of a tower. This would be a round brick. Something like this. Oh, did you all see the light tower? The lighthouse set coming out? Are y'all going to spend $300 on that? So this will be fun because you can make this really tall with these guys, but I think you can also do a panel. Missy Elliott. Pop it, flip it, reverse it. And then she says, wrist rep. And I'm like, what? What is she saying? Beth's a huge fan of that song, and every time that backwards part comes up, I'm like, what does she say right there? She's like, I don't know. Did I miss it? There's a huge panel, quarter panel. It's this, but without the... Maybe it's not a panel. Quarter... There we go. This guy. Which does come in tan. Look at that. Did these guys? Yes. Okay. Again, one of these may have to be... I have to figure out an entryway for that, too. And, like, how big we're going to... how tall we're gonna make it, but let's see, round plates. Brick Pasta is here. What, now it's a party. Let's see, that big, does that actually, these both come in that color, outstanding. I'd rather this. 60 cents, not bad. So I'm not worried about there actually being a functioning lift in here, but you can give the indication if you want. I wanted all four of these. Thank you very much. I think sometimes my keyboard just doesn't... What the actual F? Okay, I've highlighted all those. Copy. Paste. I think I need new batteries for my keyboard. Butchop was awake and watching the entire stream today, right? And giggling about it? Hope so. Also, FYI, one can still chat in dad stream chat. The fun never stops. Yeah, I should. I know he'd asked me about dad stream chat. I should pop into that once in a while. I think it'd be fun. So that needs to be about that big. And then we'll do one of these. And we'll move that. Nope. That over to there. Have a little control tower here. put this on there to hold it in place. Actually, I don't want those individually on there. Let's do another one of these. And then one of these. So thanks for joining me, everybody. This is just fun screwing around in studio trying to get some ideas for a terraforming base, because my idea to have a whole series of terraforming space stuff, themed ships and rovers and bases and stuff, is not something ideas will take. So I thought, well, I'll just do one for myself, and then maybe if it's a good enough, like, large base, I can submit it for an ideas thing. So with some nice graphics, have a logo for TerraTron. I think that'd be cool. We'll put another one of these round buggers up here, slightly smaller, and then surrounded by these guys again. Some stability. I have to play with the stability aspect of this and see how well it holds up, because these quarter panels tend to be a little finicky. And I also want this to be a little bigger. Like that. And then brick. Wait, we can't end it already? The day is young. I'm still stuck on flip it. Flip it, smack it. Jump it up. Okay, so this will be your observation tower, which means there needs to be windows in here. And let's put a guy in here. Let's put a terraformer in here. Don't necessarily think it has to be a guy. So it has to be that tall. In the middle, we'll put some computer stuff. This may not need to be that tall. Let's get rid of one layer of this and put one layer of this down there. And lower that. Because I'm thinking if it's going to be... Although you could make it that tall, I guess, if you wanted to. Is that lined up? It's not. Okay, good. I think one more layer of this. And you know what? I'm going to replace all these with snot bricks. Brick modified. Just because I want a Greeble. He's coming tan. Yes, they do. 12 cents. Bam. So, Michaela, what questions other than... does it suggest parts to you? Do you have about the software? Because somebody didn't go to my talk then at Brick Rodeo. What's up, Missy? Everybody congratulate Missy on her first meeting yesterday, her first TechSlug meeting. That was really awesome. And I was a big bonehead and like, and what's your name? Yeah, you were probably teaching sticker stuff, so... what am I looking for? Brick. We're not at the visual window section just yet, so... That's true, and when I met you in person last time, I was surrounded by like news cameras and a bunch of people looking at the Capitol, and I was just like, ah. I was like, I promise I'll talk to you in a minute. All right, so congrats on the tech slug. Here's $20. Go see a Star Wars. This is something, this is not a new thing to anybody, but it's one that's been used in like a bunch of snot builds. If you stack two of these, you cannot put a plate here, right? The distance between these two studs is not plate friendly. So you have to use these guys, either this or the 2x version. You have to do that, right? But if you want a long thing like that, so you can either put two next to each other, which is also too short, because then you have to put a plate on top of it. This is also a fun thing to do. You can put these two in here like this, and that will give you the distance of one plate. So you can do that. And the reason I'm going to do that is because then I can put little computer consoles right here. So I can do this all the way around. Oops, got rid of my background. And these don't have to be this color because they are being covered. So let's see, 12 cents, 10 cents. Yeah, these might be better off as a different color. What is one of those? 12 cents, 30 cents. Yikes, maybe tan is the best color. Light blue gray, 9 cents. Okay, what about light blue gray for that? 11 cents. So let's do that for all these guys. Great. What is Snot OK's least fave? Meeting people in person, that snot technique? Least fave what? Least just favorite thing overall? I don't know. Michaela, what is your least favorite thing? I don't think Michaela doesn't like meeting in person. I think they like people. And they do really well talking to people, too, so I don't think that's it. Kleenex? James, tissue paper, or tissue, facial tissue, it's not Kleenex, unless it's actually Kleenex. Least fave. Maybe I can interpret. Whoops. Trying to scroll back on my chat. Pasta? Maybe it was a pasta thing? Nope. No idea. She was teaching. That's what I know. That's one of my least favorite. Oh, okay. Where I can leave anytime. I don't like the snot brick stacked. You can't do the plates on top. I don't like the snot brick stacked. You can't. Yes. Yeah, I agree. That it's frustrating me that you can't do that. And you have to have those other ones. And there's a plate up there. But whatever. So now I get to do a slope modified. Printed. Where is it? Or that. No, that is printed. Decorated, yeah. Where is it? It's not slope inverted. Slope 30. Let's just look up slope 30. There we go. Okay. That's what I wanted. So there's a bunch of different control panel ones. I think this is the one I was looking for, is a dark gray. You can put whatever you want over here. I think they've come up with a few more. Plus, you can probably put a couple of these guys in there somewhere. I just like the looks of these. So that's cool. That's a nice little control tower thing. Oh. Anyone remember the smell of Xerox? Yeah, that like ozone smell. All right, so now we need windows. Now the easy thing to do would be to do just a big panel. Like this. I think these are the clear ones. What is that? Is this a dual mold? Fixed glass. That's pretty cool. What colors do those come in? White and blue. All right. So what about this? What colors do those come in? Transparent black. I want to keep with transparent black because that's what I have on their visors and that's what I have on the ships. So far, I think transparent black makes more sense when you are on a planet or in a hostile environment and you don't, I mean, this is just me thinking about it. If you have just a trans clear, just wide open clear glass, there's like stellar radiation, maybe that kind of thing that can blind you. So the idea of these being slightly tinted, I think makes more sense. And then I'm going to put another brick up here to give it a little more height before we put a roof on it. I may go back and just make this a brick. It doesn't have to be a... And now we got to fill in this corner area. And we've got these. But I think there's... That blocks off a lot of... Do we have curved panels? We've got these guys, and we might be able to snot build them so that they are a little rounded like this. Like, we can put these in here somehow. But I don't think these come in anything but like white. Yeah. So maybe not those. I need those parts with buttons to have sound functions. Bebop, danger, call your mother back. I didn't call my mom for a couple weeks. Just like it was one of those days I was like, oh, I've got time tonight, I'll call my mom. And then I go to sleep. And then like I do that for like a week. And by then it's already been a week since I called. And I was like, ugh. So I called her yesterday. She's like, I really wish you would call more. I'm like, oh, mom. So, why? So I can listen to bad news every time I call? This is looking fantastic. Thanks, Zizu. It's looking okay. I think it's a little boring, but I will greeble it up a little bit. This is just kind of playing around, having fun. Trying to think of like ways to make this. So I do call my mom. I just usually call once a week. Just forget every once in a while. Plus, I was moving kids into college, and there was work stuff and health stuff and whatever. Brick round. These guys... What does that look like? Oh, that's pretty cool. Can I get those in trans anything? Trans clear. Of course. These come in trans clear, really? For a buck, wow. Interesting. Okay, well, good to know. Yeah, klaxons would be great. What are those? Those are going to be modified plates. Let's see if I can find those. Because it's a 1x2. Which I've already gone past 1x2. It's not called a klaxon, is it? No. Thruster, no. Plate, cone, oops. Plate, cone. I know what piece you're talking about. One by two. Mod. I like how they rebuilt those on the Galaxy Explorer too, with the, like, the truncated cones. Oh, let me turn the printing off. I don't need that anymore. It had like the Travis brick, and then it had like the cones, the truncated cones on either side. That was really neat. That was a lot of fun. These guys. These guys. These guys. It's a 1x2 plate. Maybe it's a 1x2 brick. Maybe it's a modified brick. 3963. Yep. Brick modified loudspeaker. That's what it is. These come in gray and black and white. They do not come in tan. No, that's okay. Light bluish gray. 10 cents. Perfect. Stud Cities, how's it going? So yeah, these would be great underneath. I'm going to put a round plate. Dark gray. I wish I could see under there. Rotate. Does that bump into that thing too much? Nope. That's not bad. Also, maybe it could sit up here. Like that. That might even be better. Because then I can put some dots in there, and I can put another layer of whatever in here. And I took a stab at the microscope. I saw that. That was really cool. The Vader Snowspeeder. I love doing that kind of stuff. So I forgot to show this off. If you've been watching on Instagram, I've got all the theme bent Star Wars ships in like classic, not classic, but like 80s, 90s. Space styles, Futron, Blacktron, Ice Planet, and M-tron. Somebody said, oh, Slave One as the Atlantis series. And I'm like, yeah, that's not wrong. That's the same colors, you know. But I also forgot that I had this, which I'm also going to bring to the party. Classic space snowspeeder. And the whole reason I did this one is because I had two orange spacemen. And I was like, I think this was a build contest of like, mix up a theme or do something like that that we had. So this will go with the set too, even though this is classic space. It was super fun. I'm trying to think of another one to do if I've got time, because I still have, like, I could do the T-16 Skyhopper. I'm trying to think of little ones that I can just kind of replace. And none of these, I posted it in a Discord group and they're like, do you have instructions? And I'm like, Lego has instructions. Just change the part color. I didn't change anything really. The only thing that got changed is like the cockpits on all the stuff are different because they don't make them in like trans yellow or trans bright orange. So rotate 180, 135. Nope. 125. And then 315, yes. Yeah, this definitely gives it an air of that sort of old style space. I think this is one of those pieces that definitely gives it that feel. Here's your studio clip or trick of the day. Let's see, that's 90, so it's 45. If you have a piece and you have snap turned on, which I do, so that you have your pieces snap to a stud or a tube underneath or whatever. If you want it to be put on something and you know it'll fit and you're going to turn it later. So let's do this one again. They're going to want to snap to two angles, 90 degree angles. They never snap to 45, even if you turn them. Like this, if you've got it, like I know it's going to be a 45 degree angle. As soon as you move it, it's going to snap back to a 90 degree angle. That's just the way the software works. But let's say you want it here and you're like, well, knowing that, if you just hover over where it's supposed to go and hit space, it'll force it to connect, even though there's a collision. And then you can turn it. So this then goes to 235. So there you go. So that's really cool looking, actually. Thanks for the suggestion, James. That actually needs to be turned more. To 25? Yeah, 70 minus 45. Okay. All right. So then I know I've seen this work in other builds. Put another thing like that. The only reason I don't like that is it's not sealed. But a lot of those old space sets weren't sealed. So I'm okay with doing this. Could even have something else come out of here. Let's take a look at what we can do here. You can do, we've already got this. So this can be, I mean, this can be simple. If we're going with the green theme, this can be green. And this can be, where's my, is it tile modified? Yeah. Cool. And then we can have another. Bracket. Do bracket. These do not. These come in tan? 60 cents. No, thank you. Mm-hmm. And then just anything really. You can put those levers. Put these on there. I don't think these come in. Wow, they do come in tan. Tan and gray. Lever base. I just like this piece. Oh, but it's $2. No, thank you. Do they come in gray? I think they come in gray. Light blue gray? Yeah. Let's see what else could go here. Like these pieces, just stick those in there. Burp. Or antennas. I like things looking like sensors. Just stick antennas all the way out. Or a bunch of those would be weird looking. Yeah, so maybe not. Oh, this is great. I'm going to put this up here. You guys get the Cubs game? So let's get rid of these. Hinge things or brackets. Don't need those. Maybe too much. I still want to kind of fill in this with some sort of so there is a plate round that I can turn these guys. Yeah, see what I mean about it doesn't matter what angle you have it at. Let's see if that's lined up. It doesn't quite line up. 45 and 45. Okay, I don't know what this music is, but I'm not a fan. So it doesn't have to be completely have I seen pictures of Emil with his collection of microfighters on an exhibition? I have. His thing too is he brings Emil has built a large fleet of microfighters. He also brings like all of the store-bought microfighters with him. And I don't honestly know if he's actually designed any of his microfighters. I think he has. I don't know for sure. I haven't seen him post anything in a long time. But he was very, very, like, he would just tell people, he's like, I have the largest fleet of microfighters in Europe. It's like, okay, like, kind of aggressively. I'm like, that's cool, you know. But I think he was getting most of them from other designers, which is fine. However you want to get your stuff. So he's a big displayer of other people's builds. But I think he's been doing his own, too, I think. This song isn't any better. Oh, God. Can I... Oof. Yeah, he does. He's like, yeah. And he does it, like, I know there's a cultural difference. He's Swedish. So I think it's missing something in translation. But every time he gets a design of mine, he messages me, first of all, and is like, can I have instructions for the, for one of these? I'm like, they're online. You can get them. And he's like, okay. And then he'll show me pictures of like somebody else's model. He's like, can you get me instructions for these? I'm like, well, that's not mine. I can try to reverse engineer it for you, but I mean, try to go through the person who made it and see if they'll get you instructions. And he's like, okay. And then he comes back like a month later. I couldn't. Can you do it? I'm like, sure. So I do it. And then he's like, okay, that was great. I changed all this stuff. And I'm like, okay. And then he'll get one of mine and he's like, I built your thing, but I changed a bunch of stuff. I think it's better. I'm like, you're so weird, you know. Why? I was like, yeah, it looks cooler. Some of these designs are 3 or 4 years old. Like, there's newer pieces. And I'm not like the end all be all of designers. Of course you're going to run into stuff that's better. It's just, I think it's funny. Like if I just did a brick without a tube, because I can make this trans black, that's gonna bump into that, isn't it? Can't really tell because they are the same color, but yeah, you can see the clipping right there. That won't work. So we can do brick round. Get one of these guys. I think these guys can come in that color. No. Okay. What about this guy? So one of these does. No? Okay. I thought it did. That's going to change stuff. Got to be a panel. I thought there was a panel. You haven't seen him post in a while or comment on stuff. He's usually pretty active on the comments, which means in about a week, I'm going to get a thing that says, can you make me this? The funniest ones are when he'll send me a Facebook message. And there's like 4 or 5 different images, like renders of microfighters. And 3 of them are not mine and 2 of them are mine. And they're all of the same ship. Or like he wants to do 2 or 3 ships and he sends a bunch of images over. And he's like, can you make instructions for any of these? And like 2 of them are my design. And I'm like, I haven't. Two of those are mine, man. Of course I can make instructions for those. I'm going to do another door here just to make it look like, why is that not centered? Oh, this is only a 3x door frame. That's not going to work at all. That's a window frame. I may end up building a door frame instead. That's fine. Oops. And this comes in that color, great. Yeah, I'm kind of like, every time he's approached me in the last little bit, I'm like, those aren't mine, and I just kind of leave it. And then if he says he wants me to do one thing or another, I'm kind of like, they're already on Rebrickable. You can go get that if you want. Yeah, bunch of Razor Crests. He's also done, like, if there is a Delta 7 or Delta 7B, like the triangular the word's gone. Jedi Interceptor, not the one with the wings, but the triangle one. He'll do like 5 colors of that one. Which you're supposed to do. Like, I'm going to do a bunch of different colored Y-wings. I'm going to do a bunch of different 7Bs. But that design isn't mine yet. Like, I'd like to redo it and kind of do it on my own and see if I can come up with a design. So that's why I don't show it off. I've got like 10 microfighters that I don't show anywhere. They're just sitting on my shelf because they're not my designs. I would feel bad taking not my designs to a convention and showing them to people. It's like, look what other people have built. That's why I don't do it. I know some people do. They'll mod it slightly and go, hey, look at this. It's like, okay, you've modded a thing. Good job. I just had a dope idea. I wonder if this will work. Is this the right round? No. Is this the right round? No. Is this? No. That is. That's where it's at. Maybe not. Maybe this? Oh god, that's so big though.
That's what she said.
I just wanted a little bit. I can probably swing that though. Rant timer. Your time allotted has been maxed. Yeah, I know. I mean, but we went through that, did we not? Recently, a couple months ago. How do we rate that? How do we judge that? It's not really that design. It's not really that person who showed up that built that. That's somebody else's. How do we categorize that? Yeah, and that's the other thing. Like, so there was a person at Brick Rodeo that did that. They had a table full of stuff that they bought the instructions off Rebrickable, right? Or Brick Vault. And they built it. And they were all very neat looking, but it wasn't their design. It was just they built a model. They might as well have just bought the set at a store and built it and gone, look at this, you know. But they did have a QR thing up there that's like, these are all built by different people. Here's all their sites. Here's their, you know, go support them. It's like, right on, you know. And they had one or two that were like, the same thing. It was like, it was somebody else's, but they modified it slightly. So it's, you know, so it's like, do you really do that at a convention though? I mean, do you do that as a, I don't know. So this is what I was thinking of doing with this. So if he's doing that at shows where he's like, look at all my stuff. And it's like, that's not, none of that is your stuff. Nobody calls him out on it. He's just going to keep doing it. Is that gonna conflict? I also loved, I'm such a jerk about this. I also love seeing, people post like on Instagram and whatever else, and it's just like this giant thing of just sets, right? It's just a room full of sets. They're all together. It's a giant collection of Star Wars sets. That's fine. I'm okay with that because, I may not even need these. Oh, well, structurally, I still need that. It's fine to have a collection, right? You can have a big thing of pop figurines, or you can have a big thing of like, snap tight mech models or Gundams or My Little Pony or something, right? Just have a wall full of that or a room full of that. That's fine. And so people who put together, all their sets and they put them up on shelves and it's a giant collection. And it's obviously they've, you know, spent their paycheck on it. I'm the dude who comes into the comments and goes, sweet, where are all your mocks? Let's see all your mocks. Because I'm that dude. And of course, I never get any response because why would you? The paper with the information is Swedish. He's got my name on the. Oh, that's good, you know. I don't really know where I'm going with this. just playing. This is kind of fun. The fun thing about playing is just seeing what you come up with. Brick. What time is it? Oh, we got about 20 minutes. I try not to rag on people too much because any interaction with Lego, I feel, is a good interaction with Lego. If you're building other people's stuff, that's good for the other people whose stuff you're building. If you're building your own, if you're designing your own stuff, that's great. You're taking the time to do it. If you're just building sets and you've got a big collection of sets, that's money that you're spending on those sets. That's great. I try not to harp on people too much about it. It just sometimes it gets in my craw that there's a little, you know, there's people who are doing a lot of really good design work that aren't being recognized because there's other people who are building armies. And it's like, nobody cares how big your bank account is, dude. It's like, it's not even really an impressive display of models or anything. You're just, rant time, sorry. That was a good interaction. Scalper's interaction with Lego is trash. That is true. I will agree with that. All right, so this is a neat little collar for this interaction here. The way this interacts with this. I have to build it up a little bit. I don't like where I've left it down here on the ground, but I think that's easily rectifiable. And I can do, these are facet bricks. If I can get a couple of these facet bricks. Yeah, I don't like people who, you know, wipe out a store of all its gift with purchase or all of its brand new whatever, and then you see it on Mercari like 2 days later. You're like, really, dude? You're ruining it for everybody. The title of the information is the biggest microfighter collection in the world? Question mark. Probably. I mean, he can have it. I'll pitch mine as the largest collection of my own creation microfighters. And we'll just leave it at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Brick 6. So I might interrupt this with a little plate. This is obviously probably too complicated for the whole shebang, but I don't think I can get a tile in there now. I think that's too tight a fit. Yeah, so might try to do something different. Do modified brick. Do a bunch of these. Don't come in tan. Oh, they do. 13 cents. Not bad. 136 microfighters, and he says he has at least 50 more at home. Well, good for him. Panel. Oh, that's not going to work. So I'm at an impasse with this because I don't want to leave. Well, I don't honestly care. Yeah, and I think he's... I agree with you, and I think he's at the point where it's bordering on weird because he's, like, really pushy about getting more at the expense of, like, not recognizing sec, moc. I had to be really careful with that first word. And credit and, you know, stuff like that. And it's like he's giving proper credit. That's fine. Just, you know, kind of be cool about it. But he's been kind of a fan for years. So, that's cool for me. And again, you know, any interaction with Lego is other than scalping, other than the nefarious sales practices. Oh, that's too much. Is cool by me. All right. This is getting a little harried. Weird is not the right term. Don't harass me. Yeah, the thing is, if nobody checks on that, James, the Guinness stuff, it's like, see, that doesn't even fit. What the heck? This is where I'm so frustrated at the math sometimes that I don't. See, that works. That's nice. I don't know why that doesn't work. Because these stupid things. See, here's that. Brick, plate. To get that lined up with that. Ugh. Oh, yeah. Walter, I can't imagine not having a list of what I've got. Just so I'm not double building something. I also want to make sure that, like, all the renders that I do that I post online, if it's not mine, I'm giving credit. I'm like, here's their Flickr page. Here's their Instagram, you know, stuff like that. Did he ask you to make instructions of one of my... Oh, my God. Here's the thing. They're microfighters. They're 100 pieces. Like... If you can kind of sort out how to build it so it looks like what you're looking at, you're like 80% there. There's so few little things inside of that to make it look like that, that you're just building what you see is like more than halfway done with that. I don't know. I've started to get on a No More California train. They end up being conservatives escaping cool parts of California to force their vision of Texas on me. That's why we're moving to Canada. Austin's fun and all, but it's... I don't know. See, I'm frustrated because this works really neat. It's a neat fit. But it's causing problems to, like... fill in the rest of this, so I don't know. I thoroughly enjoy the creative challenge on microfighters. I do too, which is why I do it. I like trying to make something that is 7 kilometers long into a 8 long, you know, brick, 8 stud long Lego build. That's the fun part. Ooh, I wonder if... if I do a brick modified, there's like a half a chance that these are a little... These are better. Because it's got a... dip into that plate a little bit more. What's up, yo? What's up? What's up, not Doc? How's it going? How's life? Thanks for being here. Yeah, you know what, Walter? He said that for years now. There is no computer program. There's no computer that doesn't support Studio. I don't know what he's working on. He must be on like a 10-year-old Mac or something. Because I'm like, he's like, yeah, my computer doesn't support it. I'm like, did you build your own computer out of parts from the Stone Age? Studio's been around now for like 5 years. Like, there's, you must have just the oldest of computers. PhD program in British Columbia. Good luck with that. See, and here's the other thing. Now this will fit, right? We get one plate in here, but now it won't be nice. And, oh, it still won't fit. Come on, man. What is going on? Why won't this just... Oh, it boggles the mind. Oh, it has nothing to do with the... Yeah, it's just off-centered. So, I did that. Then I did a tile here. Well, we may end up in... yeah, we may be going to Vancouver. I don't know. It's hard to kind of figure out what we're going to be doing because... I can probably get a job anywhere because of IT. Beth can get a job anywhere because of social work, but she also was thinking about going and doing a PhD program or another master's program at a different, you know, for something else. So I don't know. We're going to go visit Montreal next year. I think I'd still like to visit Toronto. I told her, I was like, we should go to Nova Scotia and just visit Nova Scotia. She's like, no, it's too cold. I'm like, it's right next to Maine. And she's like, yeah, and Maine's too cold. I'm like, but you're okay with Toronto? You know, I don't know. Toronto? Portugal seems a great place for Americans to live. Just saying. Yeah, it's on our list. We want to visit. All right. You know what? I'm done with that. Okay. I'm going to move over to something else. Let's do a quick little... make this a little more fun over here. Let's do this. Give this a little landscape feel. A little offset. Maybe like this. And another one over here. Like that. And then I'll put another one of these here. That's good. And then maybe this guy over here. That's good. Okay. And like that. That's good. Okay. Just doing something else. Get my mind off it. I've heard it's great. It's pretty. It's the climate's great. The cost of living's not prohibitive. The people are nice. So we've got, let's see, tower, observation tower, control tower, a thing for plants. Maybe we'll have like some rooms over here and then maybe a dock for a spaceship. So let's make this, let's do a platform So let's do a big 8x16 tile. Oh, you know what? I bet these road plates would be great. What color are those coming? Just dark bluish gray. Are you kidding me? These road plates come in pink. Bright pink. And flamingo pink. What sets are those in? I guess friends? That's amazing. Look how many colors these plates come in. I am smacked of gob. That's just wild. However, they don't come in tan. Okay, well, there's that. Let's build one out. Let's do a 8x16 plate. That's a pretty good size. And then we'll put tile modified. These. It doesn't tell you what set it's in. Let's go back. It doesn't tell you here what set it's in, but like if you clicked on it and then it changed the color to pink. Wait, it wasn't that one. It was this one. This one's pretty cool. I should do that one. Does that come in tan? It does not. Dark tan though. And I could fill it in with tan. That's pretty cool. For a dollar. So yeah, let's look at this one and say, okay, well, this comes in bright pink, right? You click on the number and it'll open up the page and then you can say it comes in 31 sets. But I don't even think after that, known, bright pink 2, it won't tell you what. Lots for sale, unwanted list, known colors. Like, it doesn't say what sets have just the pink one in it, I don't think. So you can do 31 sets, and you can see what sets it comes in, but it doesn't say which ones. Oh, wait, no, it does. You can filter it. White, light bluish gray, medium nougat. So if we scroll down to bright pink, it is a junior set, friends. So this one. So that's the base for that house. And this one. Cool. So there you go. Yeah, you have to sort, go through the color list. That's pretty cool. Not like I'm going to need those. Okay, so we're going to do this. We're going to do this a couple times. In dark gray. Dark gray. Where's dark gray? And that, and this. And that, and that. Okay, well, we got about 5 minutes left before I turn into a pumpkin. This was fun. Thank you all for being here. I need to do printed tiles. I think what I'll do is go into... I need to design a logo for TerraTron and go into Parts Designer and start putting that logo on tiles and slopes and things like that. So... I actually don't like the round one. Let's just go with a square. And then those are 3x. 7. So let's do a 1x3 tile. Copy, 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 copy. 1x6. And then a 2x6. And here's where we get dodgy because, we do. There are 2x6 tan tiles. Nice. And then a pylon. Really? It's not a pylon. What is it? A support? Before I turn into a watermelon. These, but they're a bit big. That's too tall. Oh, those are cool. What color do those come in? Light gray? Not bad. I was doing a power station. I don't know if you guys ever saw the power station that I was working on. I'm gonna pull it up because I think it's fun. I was doing a modular, an idea for a modular power station to put in between houses and stuff, like a substation. But I was running out of like things I could do with like some of the pieces, and it was getting expensive. So like, and I was redoing the inside of this, but like you could put this in between two buildings on your city street, right? I thought it was cool. It originally had two trucks. Like, there's a couple sets, that have utility trucks that are perfect. And so it was like, you could just get a couple of those trucks and they go with this set, and that set becomes part of more of those utility things. Doesn't get cold enough and there's too much limestone. Yeah. Designing printed tile stickers, packaging, and miniature art used to be my job. I'm a fan of vector art. Oh, cool. Yeah, so in this, there is a... it's not in this program. It is... where did I put it? I thought it was in here. Yeah, parts designer. So it opens up a new, like, I don't know why it's not just opening from the program. I thought I had it. Parts designer. Yeah, I thought I had that already. I don't know why I don't have it anymore. Power station, yeah. So this was, I redid it because I was having a hard time with fences. These pieces don't come in new gray. They're very expensive. So I was trying to come up with a good look for chain link fences because power stations always have chain link fences, right? So I was trying to think of a good way to do it. I was looking at netting. I was looking at like just doing bars with like clips on them. This was the best solution I could come up with, but it was kind of an expensive solution, and kind of finicky. Like it probably would fall apart really easily. But I just like the look of some of this stuff. And then this was pre being able to bend tubes and strings. So in the original design, I just had strings kind of like sticking out going, okay, and imagine that you can put a string here and it'll like drape in between the two like a power line. But this was, I don't remember when this was, like if I close this, I don't know how old that file is. It's at least 4 years old, but the mesh, which has been on Friends Boat, would be great chain link. Cool, I'll look into that. So that's that. This piece reminded me of that. If you look at, I'm going to do this real quick and then we'll... I really thought that I'd already had this installed. Maybe it's on... I have it on my work laptop, maybe accidentally. Accidentally. I mean, I put it on there and then was just like, I probably shouldn't be doing that on here. So, parts designer is really cool because it does two things. It can put... it can put art on a part, but you can also design parts. So let's look at, let's just look at this. So you can change. So here's your menu. You can create a part. Like you can create a 5 long brick, right? And then on it you can put your artwork. So if you've designed an image to go on it, I'm trying to find, because I haven't played with this a whole lot. You can change the connectivity on a piece. Like if you don't want it to have any connectivity on these tubes or on the tops or whatever. You can also do, you can take away or add studs to stuff. It's fun. You can like build whole pieces just to be able to do whatever you want. But the decal part is, so if you have a file, I don't really even know if I have anything. Like I don't have a, let's do a robot. So I can do this, just do a robot. So if I had a big tile, I could put this elements. Select. Yeah. So, I mean, I have to play with it a little more, but then you can put like whatever your artwork is on a tile, and then you can, I think you can export that and then put it into Studio so that when you render your Studio file, it'll have like the image that you made in here, something like that. So, it's pretty cool. I know very little about it, but I want to play with it so I can do some stuff. I want to do the Q2 logo to put on my stadium, along with the Austin FC badge to put on the stadium too. So when I do a render, which I should have done originally with this, but I haven't done that yet. So it looks nice, right? So it looks like the actual thing. So that's what that's for. Yeah. You can do the same thing. You can scale. I don't think you can do a whole lot of twisting or anything like that. It's pretty basic. I think you can import... so you can import a studio part, decorated part, 3D object from one of these other things to put a thing on. And then I think you can do... I think you can export... Yeah, you can export it as export to Studio. So it'll create an IO file, and I think you have to dump that into a folder that will import into your palette. So it's a different, it's a bunch of different work. I'm not really familiar with it, but I should go through it so I can be more familiar with it. So, cool. Well, I'm gonna save this and I'm gonna get off the computer and go do some other stuff. But thank you guys very much for hanging out. It was good talking to everybody. If 30923. Let me put that in there so I can remember that for... Yeah. See, that'd be great. That'd be perfect for a fence. Just put an antenna in there. Or have it held up by something. Perfect. Thanks, everybody, for being here. And I hope you have a great rest of your weekend. And I probably will try to be on Tuesday, but I think, oh, that's a problem. It only comes in black. I will try to be on Thursday, but I think I've got something going on Thursday. So over on Twitch, if you guys want to watch on Twitch, I'll probably be doing more of this stuff. I did get a new set that I can build. I've got a couple sets I could build. I got this. I got a couple of these. One for me, one for our lug. So we have this to give away as part of our lug thing. So I may include this at some point. But also I could build it on stream. So I may do that on Twitch. Yeah, we'll see what happens. So take care. Good talking to you guys. And have a good weekend. Bye.